Her due date is getting closer and closer, with Meghan expected to welcome her first child with Prince Harry in April, but the mother-to-be shows no sign of putting her feet up. Kensington Palace has today announced that the Duke and Duchess of Sussex will visit Morocco later this month. The royal couple will visit the African country from Saturday 23 February to Monday 25 February and are expected to undertake 2 days of engagements. It is thought that Meghan will be around 30-32 weeks pregnant when she travels, as while she has not revealed her exact due date, she previously told fans she was due between late April and the beginning of May. According to the NHS, Meghan will be safe to fly, as most airlines allow expectant mothers to travel up until the 37-week mark. Their visit comes almost 4 decades after the Queen had what has been described as her tour from hell on the country. In 1980, the monarch, then 53, visited Morocco for the first and last time as part of her 2-week-long tour of Italy and North Africa. King Hassan II was in power at the time, and royal biographer Robert Hardman previously claimed that the king had been overly cautious following 2 attempted assassinations, resulting in various last-minute changes. A foreign official at the time said of the trip, "It was a unique state visit, and that nothing that had previously been arranged actually took place as arranged." At one point, the Queen is reported to have been left alone sitting in the sun for most of the afternoon by the King, The Express reported last year. Several other engagements did also almost not go ahead, but the monarch had insisted attending in order not to disappoint the public. Despite the hiccups on the tour, the 92-year-old monarch was said to be fond of King Hassan, and even wrote him a letter of thanks. "We will next see Harry and Meghan on February 12 when they will visit the Natural History Museum." The Duke and Duchess were last seen on Thursday night when they attended the Endeavour Fund Awards in London's Draper's Hall. Meghan, 37, dressed her baby bump in almost head-to-toe bespoke Givenchy, pairing a crisp white shirt with a side-split skirt and box clutch by the designer, which she teamed with £530 Aquazura Rendezvous pumps. As they moved around the pre-awards party at Draper's Hall, Harry was heard to tell one invitee, "There's a heavy baby in here." For her part, Meghan told one guest, "He's going to be the best dad." The engagement comes in the wake of an explosive People magazine article published this week in which 5 close friends of the pregnant Duchess spoke out on the emotional trauma she has experienced as the result of abusive comments on social media and the ongoing public feud with her father Thomas Markle. One gave an account of how Meghan had done her utmost to support her father, despite him betraying her by cooperating with a paparazzi photographer over staged photo shoots. After the wedding, she reportedly wrote him an emotional letter, which was given almost verbatim to the magazine, asking him to stop victimizing me through the media so we can repair our relationship. He replied, apparently, requesting a photo opportunity. The group of unnamed friends also voiced their concerns about the effects the strain could well be taking its toll on Meghan and Prince Harry's unborn child. "We worry about what this is doing to her and the baby," they said. "It's wrong to put anyone under this level of emotional trauma, let alone when they're pregnant." Another voiced concerns over the global bullying Meghan is facing, saying, "We want to stand up against the global bullying we're seeing, against Meghan. Meg has silently sat back and endured the lies and untruths.